I don't normally do tech videos, but this one is important. In today's video, I'm going to replace the fans on an older GPU. It's an older AMD 7950 series, but believe it or not, they're still going from between $200 and $400, which shows the insanity in today's GPU market. Anyway, before we get started, go ahead and hit the subscribe button right here. Here's the card we pulled out. Now, there's one thing I do not like about these cards. On this particular card, you can't take the fans off without disconnecting everything from the GPU and the motherboard, which is kind of a pain, but it is what it is. Now, I ran some speed tests on this, and they started to overheat. And so looking at these fans, this is what you can see. One of these spins just fine, spins freely. The other one, it's kind of stuck. Not sure why. I'm just going to go ahead and replace it because I've already taken this apart and I know I can't fix it. First thing we're going to do is unscrew these little spring connectors. Set these aside because I haven't lost any, but I'm sure they're pretty hard to get. Now, I've done this on NVIDIA cards too, and the ones I've done them with are actually fairly easy to get the fans off. You don't have to go through this extent. But while we're at it, since we're going to take the GPU off, we're going to go through some cleaning and refreshing of the heatsink compound. This one's a little tough. There we go. Now, these had some old silicone pads that were just terrible. I actually just recently replaced these. I would suggest if you're going to do your fans and you have to go to this extent, go ahead and replace these little thermal pads. You can buy them online fairly cheaply. And you should also replace the thermal compound. I'll be doing the thermal compound. These pads are new, so I'm not going to mess with them. I'm going to take this one off of here. Place it there for right now. And this is not static sensitive. I'm going to set this aside. This is. So we're going to set this aside on this static bag. Now, to disconnect this, there's four little screws. And again, we're going to save these. Next, I'm going to just lift this off. If you haven't, now's a good opportunity to blow this out. I did this one already, and it's still got a couple of things in there. Before you order any fans, you want to measure it. I use this caliper. I actually like this one a lot. It's pretty useful, but I got this online. These fans are typically 85 millimeters. And you should get that. But before you order anything, make sure you're getting the right size. It's going to be important. You know, I'm not getting a direct fan to fan, or as close as I can. But 85 millimeters is going to do for this. And the opening itself is 89 millimeters. So an 85 millimeter fan is going to be fine. The other thing is you want to check the mounting points and the distance between them. Most of them that I've done are 39 millimeter. You want to go center to center, which of course is, if you're not used to it, I'm going to show you how to do this because we do this for cars as well. All right, so to go center to center, you're going to go from the outside edge to the inside edge, or outside to inside, either or, but that's going to give you a center to center measurement. Let's see if we can get this outside edge as close as possible. 38.99. So I'm going to order the fans, and they're going to be 85 millimeter fans with the mounting post being 39 millimeters off center. And we'll get those and replace them. Now, the fans are mounted with little tiny screws. Let's see if I can point that in there. You can see that there's three of them. Two, three. This is the other side of those screws. So let me go ahead and start removing those. And I will save them because nobody's going to give them to you for free. you'll notice there's little screws that are holding the wire in place, or that is holding the wire in place. Now, the sad part is that this LED, which is barely lit to start with, is not going to be replaced because the fans I ordered don't have the LED outlet, which is fine. Because, be quite honest, this one is so faint, you can't even see it. Now's an excellent time to clean this with soap and water. There's a lot of built up dust and stuff in there. The rest of the GPU is clean already, as clean as it's going to get. It's an older GPU, it's 10 years old, but I'm going to go ahead and just clean this out with soap and water, blow it off. And once everything's dried off and I get the replacement fan, we'll go ahead and put the fans back in. I will be doing one more thing while I'm waiting on the fans, and that is, I'm going to use isopropyl alcohol. I'm going to clean up this old thermal compound. And again, as long as we're down this far, we might as well clean that up and replace it with fresh one. Does it need it? Probably not. Now, to protect those little thermal pads, I'm actually going to just stick this on here. And I'm going to be doing the same thing with this guy. Take the old thermal compound off. Again, using isopropyl alcohol. I also use denatured alcohol, but 90% alcohol is just fine. All right, now we wait for the replacements to come in. Well, I got the replacement fans in, and interestingly enough, they look to be the same manufacturer as the originals, First D. Should be one with a long cord, one with a short cord, and the short cord will go towards the back. So this is the back. All right, let's get these mounted. Since this wire's got to go this way, I'm going to route it. I'll make sure that it's tucked away so it doesn't interfere with the fan. We're going to route it down that way. So it's pointed towards the bottom right-hand side of the cover. Let's get the first screw started. And I'm not going to tighten everything down until I make sure I got enough clearance with the wires. And we will have plenty of clearance with the wires. So that's good. We'll do the same thing with this fan. Have that pointing down in that direction. Now let's do the wire management, and what we should have on this is this guy should connect in here. Actually, it's going to be a hold down screw that goes there. Make sure these wires aren't in the way of anything. Get the hold down screw, and this should be good. This wire will connect to the board. These should spin freely, which they do, so we're ready to go on to the next step. We can take this off. Let's get this lined up and installed, and then the last step will be to get it installed onto the GPU itself. Alright, last thing we need to do is going to be to install it on here. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to apply the thermal compound here, place this on top, get it lined up, and then bolt it down. So I'm going to use this Corsair thermal paste, and I'm actually going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to cut a little corner off, and I'm going to use that to spread the thermal paste around. And I'm actually putting it on the heatsink itself. Oops. Don't need a lot. Just enough to bridge a contact between the heatsink and the processor. I think we should be good there. Got my little torsion screws. Now we can connect this first. Get this lined up. There we go. And we'll get these screws on there. Check to make sure everything looks seated, which it does. All right, so the fans, both spin. The only thing left to do now is mount them on a computer and run them through a test. All right, let's get that card mounted and see how it does. Hopefully it'll keep its cool. At this point, the GPU is installed. The first thing we're going to do is just make sure the fans are running, which they are. Next, we're going to run a stress test using the Furmark GPU stress test software. I don't recommend this. It can burn out your card if you're not careful. What I'll do is during this test, I won't let the card exceed 75 degrees C. But I do want to make sure that the fans will keep up with it adequately, which they do, as well as cool the GPU down fairly quickly. Once I turn the test off, which I'm getting ready to do right here, quit, and you can see the temperature dropping pretty quickly. So I'm pretty happy with this install. I think these fans are fine. I hope this video on changing out the fans on a GPU has been helpful to you. If it has, hit share and like, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.